السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We are going to read the second hadith by Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and it's narrated by Abu Huraira. Abu Huraira was a very famous companion of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. And he said that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said والذي نفسي بيده والذي نفسي بيده. It means that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is swearing by God, swearing by Allah, and Allah who owned his soul or self. So Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said والذي نفسي بيده, that I swear by Allah who owns myself. This is precisely the translation of these three words. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ. I swear by Allah who owns myself. نفس means self. نفسي myself. بِيَدِهِ. Now, if I want to translate يَدِهِ, يَد means hand, but here it doesn't mean hand at all. It's with the complement of نفسي بيده, means that he owns myself. So I will continue. والذي نفسي بيده لو لم تذنبوا. لو لم تذنبوا. And this means if you didn't make sins or commit sins, then لذهب الله بكم. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring this is the rest here. The rest means also that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let you disappear or will get rid of you or exchange you with other people. لذهب الله بكم ولجاء بقوم يذنبون. So if you didn't make sins or didn't commit sins or wrong deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let you go. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring other people who, subhanallah, who make sins or who commit sins, subhanallah, فَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى فَيَغْفِرُ لَهُمْ فَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى فَيَغْفِرُ لَهُمْ رَوَاهُ مُسْلِمْ. And this means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring another people, qawm, people, yuznibun, make sins, فيستغفرون, they say, astaghfirullah al-azim, فيستغفرون الله تعالى فيغفر لهم. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will let their sins, will delete their sins, subhanallah. What does this hadith mean? Does this hadith mean at okay, we will go and commit sins and do whatever we like, and then we will say astaghfirullah al-azim and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept us again? No, absolutely. It means, subhanallah, that we are human being and it's something natural. This is normal to commit sins. All of us commit sins. Subhanallah. This is our natural because we are not angels. We aren't prophets. We are human being. And this is very natural, subhanallah, to commit sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very happy when we ask Him forgiveness, subhanallah. So this hadith is wonderful because it's it describes the human being nature, that all of us commit sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is at-tawwab. and he likes repentance. So we are always invited to repent our sins. Subhanallah. And it's very simple. It's only we can say between us and Allah, we are alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears us all the time. He is with us all the time. Just say, Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. Astaghfirullah al-Azim wa atubu ilayh. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is at-tawwab, who always accepts repentance. This is the meaning. Subhanallah. So, in general, this hadith says, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, I swear by Allah, whom myself is of his like his who or I'm sorry, who is the owner of myself, that I swear that if you do not make sins, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring or change you with another people, qawm people, who make sins, and then they say astaghfirullah al-azim, and they repent, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fayaghfiru lahum. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.